Hello friends, today we are going to perform an experiment to determine the wavelength of sodium or mercury light using diffraction grating. And we will also perform an experiment in its extension to find its dispersive power. So here we start. So basically, what is a diffractional grating? It is an optical component with a periodic structure of a large number of parallel and closely placed slits, which diffracts light into several beams traveling in different directions. So basically, this grating looks like this. The glassy part at the center of this grating is not a normal glass. In fact, it contains very fine slits. So at some place it is rough and at some place it is clear. But from naked eye, it looks like a clear glass. The most important thing to know about this grating is its grating element. So grating element is the distance between two consecutive slits or two consecutive obstacles. Or we can also say that the width of one slit and one obstacle, means A plus B, is the grating element. So when light passes through a grating and it travels in different directions, we observe a pattern like this, in which at the center we say this is 0th order maxima, then 1st order maxima, and then n equal to 2, which is 2nd order maxima. And the condition of its principal maxima is this. So n lambda is equal to a plus b sin theta n, where n is the order of maxima and lambda is the wavelength of the light we used in this experiment. So if n is a constant and for a fixed grating a plus b is also a constant, we can understand that if we increase the wavelength, the deviation of light will also increase. Now let us start our experiment. So here in the beginning we will take one sodium lamp and we will cover this using a box which has a vertical orifice. We will also take one spectrometer and now we will place them in such a way such that the yellow sodium light coming out of the orifice will directly go to the collimator of the spectrometer. Now, to conduct this experiment to the next level, we need one grating and one stand for placing it on the prism table. First, attach this stand at the middle of the prism table. After that, place diffraction grating in this. For better clarity, we are going to look at it from this perspective. One thing you should take care that the orientation of diffraction grating should be perpendicular to the light falling on it. So we will see that as the yellow sodium light falls on the diffraction grating, so different beams of lights diffract in different directions. We can name the high intense center line as 0th order maxima, and after that at some deviation we have first order and then the second order maxima. First, we will observe our first order maxima, place the cross wire just above this line and measure its position. Similarly, move this towards right of the central maxima and observe the first order maxima towards the right side. Now let's make a table of this. So in this table, we have first observed the first order maxima towards left side. We can measure its reading in two vernier scales. After that, we have measured its position towards right side. We can also measure its reading and write it down here. After that, we can find their differences, which is equal to 2 theta. And later on, we can find out its angle of deviation, which is theta. So for better accuracy, we can repeat this experiment two more times. And finally, we can get an accurate value of angle of deviation for the first order spectrum. Now, we can repeat the same experiment for the second order spectrum. We can measure its positions, finding out the difference, and then dividing it by 2. Now, we will apply this formula. So for first order spectrum, n is equal to 1 and we will use theta 1 for calculation. And for second order spectra, n is equal to 2 and we will use theta 2. Here the quantity a plus b is not known to us. So basically, For any diffraction grating, we are given a quantity capital N, which is lines per inch available on that diffraction grating. To calculate this quantity A plus B, we can write it as 1 by N, but the unit of this quantity is inch. To convert it into meter, we just multiply this with 2.54 into 10 to the power minus 2. So here is the calculation to find out this quantity A plus B. So in this way, for first order and second order spectrum, we can find out the value of lambda, which is the wavelength of sodium light. We can also find out the error in measurement because we know the standard value of the wavelength of the sodium lamp. So in case we have mercury lamp at its place, we will have many wavelengths of different colors in our experiment. So we will make similar table as we have made for yellow color for all the colors and determine their wavelengths. Let's move towards the second part of our experiment, which is finding out the dispersive power of grating. So basically, to find out its dispersive power, we specially require this sodium lamp and we need to look at its yellow light. If you look at it carefully, you will find that this is not one light. There are two lights at this place. So now let's zoom this and watch this carefully. So you will observe a double line at this place. So first you move your telescope and place the cross wire just above the first line and note down its position. After that, move your cross wire towards the second line and measure its position. Finally, as we know, the wavelength of two lights from the sodium lamp is 5896 and 5890 angstrom. So we can easily calculate d lambda quantity by subtracting them. And let's make a table of what we have observed in this experiment. So like the last experiment, we will also find out the angle of deviation in this experiment for both lambda 1 and lambda 2 wavelengths. After that, we can calculate their mean, which is equal to theta 1 plus theta 2 divided by 2. Similarly, d theta quantity can be calculated. And finally, by the formula, the dispersive power is d theta by d lambda. But we will get this quantity in terms of degree per meter. And thereafter, we can change this quantity in radian per meter. So in this way, we can find out the dispersive power of diffraction grating for first order and second order spectrum. We also have the theoretical formula for calculating the dispersive power of a diffraction grating. Here N is the order of diffraction, A plus B is a grating element, and theta we have calculated in the previous table. And finally, we can mention out their results like this. For first order spectrum, we have found the experimental and theoretical values of dispersive power. Similarly, we have performed this for second order spectrum. Hope you like this video. If you like this, please don't forget to like and share my videos and subscribe to my channel. Have a good day.